truly a son of the soil of the prairie state. Several generations of my ancestors have called Illinois home, and so do I. One of my great-grandfathers died in a coal mine near Canton 100 years ago. Another great-grandfather farmed land in Edinburgh during the day, then went to work in a coal mine at night. He was obviously made of stronger stuff than me. While I was born in St. Louis, my parents moved to Springfield a few months later when my dad accepted a job at the state of Illinois. I grew up in nearby Rochester, and like my father, graduated from Illinois College in Jacksonville. After moving to Arizona to continue my education, I figured I might never return, but within 4 years, I was on my way to East Moline, and since then I've lived in Moline and Collinsville. My daughters attended college in Macomb and Charleston, and my job took me to towns in all four corners of the state, places like Waukegan, Orangeville, Alton, and Grayville. There may be a county in the state I haven't been in, but there can't be many. And as a brewery historian, I can name every town in the state that had a brewery, and believe me, there are a lot of them. In short, I know the state and its people intimately. Secondly, I've read through the two paragraphs describing the duties of Lieutenant Governor. While I'm not yet an expert on the Illinois River Coordinating Council, the Rural Affairs Council, Great Lakes Commission, or the Illinois Main Street Program, they all sound interesting to me, and I'm a quick learner. Perhaps I could also find time to promote other worthy causes, like Governor Quinn did when he held the office. I've always kept up with the issues facing the state, and would be happy to serve as advocate for the citizens, the governor, and the Democratic Party, especially on the issues upon which we agree. Finally, I'm going to be brave enough to stand here and propose something which will likely disqualify me in the eyes of many, and that is that rather than kicking the can down the road or raising taxes to easily solve the state's budget crisis, while I'm confident cuts can be made to the state budget, my main proposal is to enhance state revenue by legalizing, regulating, and taxing the sale of marijuana. My thinking is that we can use pot to keep the state from going to pot. This would truly put the state of Illinois on the cutting edge of reform, and I'm fully prepared to debate this issue with those who think marijuana prohibition is an effective policy. In conclusion, I'd like to thank the Illinois Democratic Committee for facilitating this process and wish you the best of luck in choosing an effective candidate who will become a competent Lieutenant Governor. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Ms. Kious. Questions of the committee?
Is there anything in your background that would cause a problem for?
Well, I got a DUI in 1997. That's ancient history to me. I probably wouldn't be to the Republicans. But other than that, no.
Mr. Welch?
Your biography says you were on the racing board from 1985 to January 2010. Were you laid off by the state or why did you
come? Laid off, yeah. That was the official terminology, laid off. I worked down in Collinsville at Fairmont Park Racetrack. The state having a budget crisis, they had to cut back, and I was one of the ones let go. Mm-hmm.
Well, Mr. Kious, surely just pointed out a question, one of the questions that you answered, I guess, in your application. You indicated that you had voted for the Green Party, but would be willing to convert back if you're put on the ticket. This is a Democratic Party, and we are the Democratic Party. Could you give your reasons, or number one, I guess, why you voted for the Democratic Party? I'd be interested to know. And then secondly, we want you back.
Well, I'm here. No, I've been a Democrat all my life, and I've always voted in the Democratic primary. But being very disappointed with the job that Governor Quinn did after his appointment, and not being a disagreeing with Dan Hines on some of the issues too, I decided I'd kind of cast a protest vote and vote in the Green primary.
Thank you, Ms. Kious.
Thank you.